I would like to thank God and mostly the Holy Spirit for giving us strength for witnessing for Jesus and the whole group which I take part tonight.
This song is a never-ending chapter of my love for you. This day is a day that you have crafted of your love to me. You're the giver of...
I'm Pastor Naibo from Mount Olive, and we are here down in Suva City for a very special program that been run by the team that came from Australia, involving our youth from Mount Olive Church in Savutalele. And it's a very exciting program for us because this is the first time that our youth is involved in distributing of tracts and books to the public, where they hear and read the story of Jesus that can also impact to the life and also for their personal experiences during life, that whatever that they face, difficulties or hardship or problems, family or individual, but we know that there's a solution that always there to solve and answer us, and that is Jesus. He's our Savior and He's our Lord, and He's always there to provide provisions and our help and also our need in whatever and time that we need Him to help us.
You're the giver of all hope, love and peace. Let your love always surround me.
Amazing I Will Preach for Jesus street witnessing event. Highlight of the night for me, sounds really weird, but a drunk guy drew on me. It was really interesting. He turned around and asked for a pair of scissors, and you know, there was a big crowd and he kind of just singled me out and was pushing me and asked me for scissors, and I didn't have scissors. I realized that he was trying to get his bag off because he's gotten tangled up in it because he was pretty drunk, and so I managed to unravel him from it, and then we just started a really interesting conversation that wasn't really going anywhere because he was quite drunk. But then eventually managed to tell him my name. He asked me my name, and he tried to write his name on my arm, but he didn't really get very far because, again, he was drunk. But I managed to write down the details of the prophetic seminars that are going to be on at Tamabua Church that the boys are preaching at. So really excited to see whether he comes. Stay tuned. Please pray for him. I don't know his name. I couldn't get it out of him. Just pray for the drunk man that the Preaching Place team met at Suva City bus station in Fiji. Thanks so much. Praise the Lord for everything that's happened tonight.
Hey guys, we're here in Suva in Fiji, and we've just finishing wrapping up one of the most powerful, amazing, most blessed I Will Preach for Jesus is that we have ever done. We have teamed up with the local Mount Olive Church tonight, the church that we're staying at a village called Savutalele, and it's just been amazing. We have gotten rid of hundreds of books, hundreds, more than 1,000 glow tracks, and we have had just some amazing conversations with people. Just like something I'm really buzzing about at the moment is I gave a book to this lady, and I walked around giving, you know, kept giving more books to other people. One of the brothers from the Mount Olive Church, Joe, comes back to me like 3 minutes later, and he's like, brother, come, this lady wants to talk to you about more books or something. And I'm like, all right, cool. So I go there and I get there, and the lady, we start talking, and she says to me, she goes that she has a factory with more than 200 workers, and she wants to give them all this book, The Great Hope, that I just gave to her. And I'm like, okay. And we start talking and we're conversing, because that's amazing that she said that, right? So we start talking, and it turns out that this lady, she's not even Christian, she's Hindu. She's an Indian lady who's Hindu, but she was just so impressed by the fact that we're out here and that we're sharing, you know, what we know and what we love about Jesus. And she says, this is the part of Christianity that I love. And she goes, give me more books, I will help you get rid of them. And we're just like, praise God, man. And we're starting on tonight's Friday. On Sunday night, we're starting the evangelistic campaign at a local church around here. And we invited her to come, and she said she's gonna come. And we also have, you know, Assemblies of God members and people from other churches and that we've spoken to tonight. And, you know, Orion was talking to a Methodist guy, and they all wanna come, you know. And man, like, God is so good. Like, this is just amazing. And, you know, all the, I don't even know what to say. I'm just so happy, I'm just so amazed. God is good. Just wanna encourage you guys, seriously, get out there and do something for Christ. People want to know about Jesus. Doesn't matter what part of the world you're in, people want to know about Jesus Christ. And you know, tonight, final messengers, you know, and more final messengers have been made tonight, because the youth of this local church, the Mount Olive Church, have been so encouraged and inspired by tonight that we know that they're going to keep doing this every month now. So I Will Preach for Jesus has come to Suva, Fiji, and he's here to stay. And God is the only one that we can thank for that. So praise the Lord. And guys, God is good. Get out there, do something for Christ. Preaching Place Australia. See you soon.
All my scars, thinking I'd gone too far, but he knew my pain, and he loved me just the same. He promised I'd be free if I fell on my knees and cried, restore me, I need your mercy. Oh, take me to the place I used to.
This is my first time to do this kind of outreach, and it really touched me. I haven't done this for like so long, and tonight is a very privilege for me to come with a team from Australia. I'm so happy. I thank God for giving me strength, confidence to stand in front of people, giving out books. I really enjoy it. And I'm touched also, because like first time I heard the group was talking about coming out and to do the outreach. I was saying, oh no, I can't do it. I can't. But tonight, when I finished from school, and I plan not to come here, but something tells me to come here. And I think the Holy Spirit talks to me to come and share to the people who needs the Lord. I really thank God for giving me the heart and heart to stand and work for him. Like, I'm the girl that, one of the girls that are very naughty. And when I heard this group was coming, and I was like, oh, let them go. Let them go. After school, I'll go back. I'll just go back straight home and wait for them. But I really thank God. Yes, I really thank God. Well, to bring me here. When I reach here, I said, what are they doing? When I look at them, and like my heart just said, go there, that's the right place to go. And I was, Okay, that's why I just went beside Sissy and the group. I stand beside them and sing, and like the shame that felt me was gone. And I'm happy to be in front of the public. Thank you.
Hey guys, it's Gerard here from Preaching Place Australia. I'm just here pretty much tonight, right now, just wanting to witness about the love of God and how He has really worked His way through this youth tonight, man. It's been such a blessing. It's been such a humbling experience. We came out here with some of the youth from the village and some of the adults and even the pastor himself. And we're just here in Suva Central at the bus station here. And we've just been handing out glow tracks and these little books. And so God has just been so good, and like we were out here, the village, some of the youth they were quite nervous at first to you know, go up to people and hand out these glow tracks and these books. But we went out with them. I took some of them, kind of you could say, under my wings, and I took them out with me, and we doubled up. And since then we kind of like nurtured them into what the experience is all about. And from that, I look around, about 10 minutes later, these youth members are like off on the other sides of the street just handing out loads and loads of literature. We came out here with boxes and boxes of literature and Steps to Christ, glow tracks, all those sorts of stuff, and they were just gone within half an hour. And so we've just been witnessing to people, sharing the love of God. It's just been amazing. I can't express enough words as to how God has been so good. And we've only been here for about 3 days. And so I'm just looking forward to what else God has in store for all of us here. So God bless, stay in touch, and please keep praying for us.
Tonight is a really fantastic night, and I really admire. This is my first time for tonight, for sharing Jesus with other people, like giving tracts and some other books, useful book for the Seventh-day Adventists. And I really want to thank Holy Spirit for guiding us and giving us strength to witness for Him, for our Savior Jesus, in this last day. And you know that everything around us is like the first tracts, we were really ashamed. So the second one coming in the third, so that's become our my strength. We are getting into strength. Strengthen our life every day. So, and especially for the ministry that come from all the way from Australia. And thank God for using you people, and may God bless you and your work about witnessing for Jesus. Thank you.
Today, Preaching Place, Final Messengers. We're here in Fiji, Suva City, we're here doing I Will Preach for Jesus, man. Like, we got here a bit late, we got here, things were a bit slow, but man, I'm telling you, ever since we got here, and we started, you know, from the beginning, it's been crazy, you know. Myself, I'll share a little experience myself. Like, we're over there, just sitting over there with the books, with the boxes, getting ready to hand them out. And, you know, it was a bit wet, a bit crowded, you know, many people just like, oh, I don't know, you know, like, everybody looked a bit nervous. But, you know, what Josh said last night is true. He said, you know, as long as you have a willing mind, that God can use you no matter what. And so, like, we were just over there, and I was sitting there getting the boxes, and there was a guy. And the guy just came and sat there, and he just goes, what's that? And so he asked what it was. We gave him some glow tracks. We gave him a Great Hope book. And he literally just said, you know, he started talking, asking about the book, and we had a conversation. We had a good talk, and it was really interesting because at first I thought, man, this guy's not even gonna wanna know about anything. But what happened is that the guy's a Methodist, and you know, we started talking. He started asking about, what are you doing? What are you guys doing here? And you know, he started asking about the literature. And so we started having a discussion, talking to the guy for ages, man, you know. Everybody else picked up the boxes, they left, and I was just like looking, trying to find out where they were. But I knew that, you know, while I was there, like, God was gonna use the other guys. But back to the story, you know, we were sitting there and he started asking questions. We were talking about, you know, prophecy, talking about Daniel, Revelation, about God's church. We were talking about many things that are happening in the world, talking about how God changed my life. And we were literally saying that the reason why we're out here, the reason why we're doing what we do, is because of what God's done in our lives. And so, you know, he realized that, you know, there's many things in the church, there's many things that are not good that is happening. But we were saying, listen, you know, God doesn't save us because I'm in some church. Although God has a church, what we were saying is that God has done something in our lives, and that's why we're here on the street sharing what Jesus has done for us. And so we were pretty much talking, questions, answers, and the guy was just, you know, listening, and you know, he would ask a question and we're listening. And I kid you not, man, by the time we finished, you know, the guy was just like amazed at God's truth, and he was so touched, man. The brother was saying, you know, like, where can I study the Bible? There's nowhere here in Fiji, really, like, local Bible studies. And, you know, we were talking about the campaign that myself and Josh are doing, starting Sunday night at Tamavua Church. And so I filled him in, I let him know what we were doing. I let him know we're doing a prophecy campaign. And I told him that we're gonna be preaching for a whole week straight. And the guy was just so touched, man, I kid you not. Before we even started, I thought in my mind, I said, man, like, how is anybody gonna wanna take anything from me? And that's just the devil putting it in my mind. But I kid you not, by the time I just said, Lord, put your words in my mouth, God spoke, man. And after the whole conversation, the guy was just like, man, what time, where? He goes, I will travel, I will come where I have to come to the campaign. And so by God's grace, this Sunday, the brother that I spoke to for like pretty much an hour, he's coming to the campaign on Sunday night. And the campaign that Josh and I entitled is Hope in These Last Days. Hope for the Last Days. And so we just want to say, man, God is good, man. Since we've been in here, Fiji, 3 days, only 3 days. But in those 3 days, God has done so much. And so we just want to say praise God, because we were late to I Will Preach for Jesus. You know, we thought it's going to be a messed up time. It's raining right now around us. But all we can say is, come rain, hail, whatever comes, snow, thunder, floods, Jesus will have his way. And so we just want to say, keep tuned for more footage. Keep watching this video, I Will Preach for Jesus, Preachingplace, the final messengers here in Fiji, Suva City. So praise the Lord and God bless.
That God will also help them individually, and also to bless our nations here in Fiji, that we must see God as our answer to our needs and our problem. And this is the recommendation that Pastor Naibo from Mount Olive, that the church and also the youth has also experiencing tonight by sharing and also distributing books to the public here in Suva. And God bless you as you continue to do this ministry in distributing books and sharing and the witness for Jesus. Thank you, and may God bless you in your ministry.
I would love to tell you what I think of Jesus. Since I found in him a friend so strong and true, I would tell you how he changed my life completely. He did something that no other friend could do. No one ever cared for me like Jesus. There's no other friend so kind as he. No one else could take the sin and darkness from me. Oh, how much he cares for me. Oh, how much he cares for me.